That's what we wanted to hear, isn't it?
Advent forces are moving a VIP through this area on board one of their...
All right, welcome everyone. Welcome to Operation Stormclaw. Redford is really good with names this run. I like the name. So we're going to rescue that VIP. He's not going to start with us. I think we're going to solely start without any cover. So it's pretty much on us how fast and far we're going to move. But we got a decent team with us. Probably a very good one, to be honest. I like it. The only thing I'm worried about is we're now in month 3. And we need to speed up the research process. Month 3 means we're going to have stun lances and a couple of other mean guys. Yeah. And prior to month number 4, we need either a higher damage output or some sort of better armor and effectively ammunition. But the enemies will now have more and more hit points, and we need some way of dealing with that. And I think month number 3 also means the good times of having 5 hit point troopers that we instantly can kill are coming to a rather rapid end. They're not going to be deployed that often.
We have a confirmed location for the VIP. Move to rendezvous. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Oh, full concealment. That's good. That's very good.
Heading out.
Perfect. Look at that. Our extraction point is here. The VIP is here. And there's high grounds there. I don't know, sometimes the map design seems to be really favorable.
It's all copy.
This here is all pretty clustered and everything's like very tightly aligned to one another. Not bad, I like it.
Location confirmed.
So on the first view it looks like an easier mission, just from the layout. Don't need to walk that far. We're in a high ground position. We don't need the extraction point is even close to it.
Moving on target.
No, not bad.
Got eyes on a hostile squad.
Yeah, and now it starts to get progressively worse. Like, that's bad news. Moving 3 position. Stun lances and the Viper. I've seen better days.
Solid copy.
3 stun lances are no fun, but 3 stun lances in the Viper, that's even less fun.
Copy that. Stepping off.
Good, we're going to take the high ground here. Probably they are going to come closer, which is fine. No, they are not. They're actually moving away. Interesting. Let me check something real quick. They moved into this direction. Where are they currently? Okay, so they are here. They are here. 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 They are completely here. Which is fine. They could go up to here. That's also an option. Is there anyone on top of this roof, by the way? Don't want to trigger 2 packs. Just a caution mechanism, guys. Yeah, no one on top here, so we can move up. Let's move to here first. We know that this is not going to trigger. I just want to see what the heck is going to look like. Global flashbang, and this here would be actually pretty good, but not going to happen. Reinforcements. Reinforcements is not super good. Global flashbang disorientation for 2 rounds. That's good. But probably not worth the additional reinforcements.
On the move. Position confirmed. Looks like hostiles over here.
Wow, big pick. 3 stun lances, 2 normal troopers, and a sector. That's rather a massive pack.
Orders confirmed on the move.
Let's just make sure we're going to be in a solid cover position here and here. So even if the guys are now moving on top of the roof, we would still be in a solid position. I want to be at a position where if they're moving up, we're not going to trigger 2 packs. That's the reason why I'm putting the guys back. Currently, we still have all the time in the world. And I do have the feeling that they're either coming up here or here. Let's take one more round of overwatches and see if they want to come on top of the roof. I don't like the position that much. If we're starting a fight here, it'll effectively mean we cannot go here. Honestly speaking, I would rather want them to be like up here so we can actually fight them. But I fear this is not possible. Yeah, because these guys are constantly standing here, which sucks. Different counter proposal, by the way. We could blow up the car and we would kill 3 of them. So if these dudes, the Viper and their friends, would decide to get the fuck away here, we could actually trigger the other pack and everyone would be happy. But it pretty much depends on what these guys are now going to do. If they are continuing to move here, we might as well trigger right away. I like their position because if we play our cards right, really they changed their position. Are you telling me they really changed their position? Wow. Last turn it was super
confirmed.
Convenient. This is a bad spot. We don't want to blow up that car, obviously, right?
Understood. Moving out.
I do have an idea, though. Like up here, we can put our long-ranged characters into a position where we're going to have a strong map overview without any downsides. And I like the idea. Here, thank you.
Moving overwatch.
Could these guys please move to the car in front? That would be much appreciated. Because if there are a car here, if they would be at the car here, that would make our life easier.
Confirmed.
Okay, so that's not a possible position, because if he will be spotted out here, that's not going to fly. The whole idea is not to be spotted out. Complicated engagement, but you guys hopefully understand we don't want to have two packs, specifically if there are new enemies that are even stronger.
Closing on target position now.
Oh wow, really? You can see them, but you can't see anyone here? Like, what the fuck?
Good copy, moving on target. On the move.
Alright, Overwatch. Come on. Is the other pack really, like, ignoring us and just move behind the car to be out of range? That would be so obviously cheating. Yeah, now they're slowly coming closer. Wow. Sometimes the attempts of the AI to
position confirmed
to cheat, quote unquote cheat, in terms of knowing your position, are a little bit pathetic.
On Overwatch.
They now know where approximately
moving to designated
we are,
position.
So they're moving into our direction. Coming which will I'm expecting these guys to come closer, and the others now to also leave their cover. Finally, like after rounds and rounds of hide and seek, they will surprisingly now leave their cover. No, they actually didn't. Well, bad luck then. We're going to approach the enemies as of now. So let's take Overwatch shots with these two, because I think we're at 100%. Yes, we are. Yes, ma'am. So it's Overwatch. It is another Overwatch. Probably the 100% shot here would make sense. That also would make sense. I'm just a little bit concerned, to be quite frank, about the option of the stun lances. So we're blocking the only entrance towards the rooftop. So if we're flashbanging them right away, they cannot move far, and they will probably not hit him, which means he's currently the bottleneck. He's Commander G is going to prevent a storm. Let's give him an 8 protocol, so in case he's going to melee attack, he still has some more cover. Good job, buddy. Here you go. That's number one. Where the fuck is the flashbang grenade? Right, we had it on top here, so no flashbang it is. Still have 100% shots. I'm okay even without a flashbang, because he should be fine. Let's take a shot here. And let the scout still have the option to take a shot afterwards. So let's see what's up.
At first, Advent deployed non-lethal stun missiles without control of the occasional protest. Woo! You see that?
Commander G. Oh, there are two of them. Clever little bastards. What's the commander going to do? He could go like here. He could be flanked, but the stun lancer is going to lance, no matter what the cost will be. We could take the stun lancer out. He It's 2 damage and 2 falling damage, 100% kill. And the other 2 lances are going to take melee attacks. So, yeah, let's do that. Wow, it really removed the whole cover. That's bad. But the lancers will try to lance anyways. And they're not going to take shots. If they can reach you, they will reach you. Wow, still got him. Yeah, it was the right decision to put him here. It's like the Zergs in StarCraft 2, and they Zerg rush you, and you just build like one building here, and you're like, nope, not going to happen, dude. Not going to fucking happen. 100% shotgun to the face, critical strike, insta-kill, and a stock. Good job. That was actually a pretty good job.
On your order.
Good job, number 2. Gremlin heal. Lance is gonna lance. Futs, that's what I'm trying to tell. that's what I'm trying to tell the chat since ages. Lance is gonna lance. Or Lance has gotta lance. That's their nature. They cannot fight it. It's just who they are. And yes, we are at StarCraft now. Wow. We can kill one of the lances. I just want to block and go into full cover here. We're going to explode most of the cars and a little bit of the cover. Yep, and that was the solid car kill. I wish we could blow up that car, but it's not going to work out, guys. We need to make sure that this is not going to burn. Trooper, easy peasy kill. Stun Lancer, not super easy peasy kill. Let's start with him. 5 points of damage, good enough for me. Sector it, we can ignore. Stun Lancer, we can't ignore. JC Phoenix is on the case.
Not good.
No, that wasn't good. JC, I have seen better performances. Not going to lie. There is the 8 protocol. There is the Overwatch. There is the 80%. Flanking.
Get me out of here, please!
On the other difficulties, there are only a couple of enemies at once, but on Impossibles, the alien decide to just go, go, go. It's crazy. Keep in mind, Impossible is a difficulty that we artificially made up. The hardest one is Legendary, and this here is actually hard, much harder than Legendary, so even on the hardest normal game difficulty, you're not having that many enemies. Just to kind of put it into a context a little bit, right? Commander G, again, gets hit. He already, his skin already starts to be scarred from all of the hits that he takes. He's like the punching ball. Arnold gets his kills. Good job, man. Let's get rid of the sick dude next, by the way. Another good job. Trooper or Lancer? I think the answer is quite simple. Lancer, of course. Damn, bro. That was a nice shot. Hey, Berensky, good evening, man. Welcome to the chat. Could you give me that little cheer sign, Berensky? Because we are doing quite well this evening. We're in a good mood. And we are pretty much owning the aliens, so I would need some cheering from your side. The others didn't know how to do the chat symbol, so it's down to you, brother, to keep us happy with the chat. Alright, we still have a couple of turns. I actually pretty much like our situation here. Yay! That's the one I was talking about. Thanks, Bransky. Good. Very good. Reload.
I'm ready.
Let's kill that guy. I'm telling you guys, that was a solid positioning overall. Really solid. Reload, steady weapon, and then we can continue.
On the move.
Another reload. We should be fine. Let's see, as long as it's not an enemy protocol or something like really good. Yeah, well, we have so many supplies. I'm saying it's not worth moving our scout all the way here. Yeah, and Commander G's anyway such a G. He's even hacking without any skill. He's just mashing the buttons and randomly transferred some cash onto his bank depot. Good job, man. That's how it's done. I told the aliens multiple times that 1234 is not an appropriate password, but probably they haven't realized it yet. This one here is, by the way, triggering. I'm pretty interested how it is, but yeah, maybe we're just like overwatching for now. JC is overwatching. Arnob can take a very, very small step forward without triggering, hopefully. Also overwatching. And last but not least, overwatch. Okay, reinforcements is not a good news.
We're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
Where are the enemies? Yeah, that was almost predictable. Shit. One tile short of just getting out of here. It is really a matter of, are we going to fight that out or aren't we going to fight that out? There is one Storm Lancer which I do not like at all. So we're probably will need to kill that guy. So we're 3 tiles short. 1, 2. Of course. What's Arnob's thing? He could go out of here. Yep. So that's not going to be a problem. Ambassador. Please. Move here. You'll get 8 protocol. What's the Advent guy with white gun? That's an Advent priest. He can heal. He's a mean motherfucker. He has better aim than normal Advents. And he has some psychic abilities. But he's mainly a defensive unit. Let me underline, he still is in the category of mean motherfucker, so don't underestimate them. Really, 5 hit points instead of 6? That is unnecessary. Don't you dare to tell me that we don't have a good position. No, maybe. Damn. I wanted to give him 8 protocols, so we're pretty much depending on that. Or the different option would be we still have a smoke grenade, so yeah, why wouldn't we want to go down here just throwing a smoke grenade in there and be like, yeah, whatever. I think that's a good idea. Full cover, and then we're going to finish the stun lancer. Good job, Arnob. Solid kill. We could go for this position. Not really sold on that one yet. Let us, first of all, move Rusticated here. It's definitely going to be a smoke grenade.
Moving to position.
Use the specialist to move up and finish the lancer, throw the smoke for it. Good thinking, Nitro. Good thinking.
Open smoke.
The VIP should be moved to here, just so we have another potential target. And the sniper, last but not least, we want to put him usually in a position where we can also take a shot, whatever. Probably we won't be in a position to do that. We could go like here and maybe take a flashbang, maybe, but probably the range will not be enough. Don't want to put him into the open, and so ultimately we put him somewhere where he has no line of sight. We want to get out of here next turn anyways, so the strategy is don't get killed. Yeah, end of strategy. That's the whole strategy. Next turn, we're going to get the fuck out of here. I would have, by the way, just for the records, completely fought that out and killed the other pack, but not with an additional pack of reinforcements. That was the reason why we have left our position. If that pack wouldn't have arrived, we would have definitely took a stance here. Yeah, another six guys, that's just too much. Not going to happen. Full cover. Overwatch. Okay. Overwatch. Guys, Overwatch doesn't mean shit. Because we do have Commander G, who's like a scout. So he doesn't give a shit about your Overwatch anyways. He's just going to trigger it and then it's GG for you. Wow, that one actually was bad. But we're going to live through it. So Commander G is the first one to move. Look at that, beautiful. Literally taking all of the shots. And being like, yeah, lightning protocol, bitch. Lightning reflexes. Fuck you. Because, yeah, fuck you. We figured all of it. VIP is going to be next. If we wouldn't have triggered all of it, the VIP still would be in the next one. Just as a principle, VIPs need to eat a couple of shots. Ambassador gets out of life here. Heavily wounded though. Arnob gets out alive. Not wounded at all. Pretty solid performance, by the way. Like it. JC to the motherfucking Phoenix. Getting out alive. Pretty solid performance. And rusticated. Good job, man. So yeah. Two wounded soldiers, excellent.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
We've only killed half of them. But yeah, that's nothing that I would consider to be bad. Worked as intended. Pretty much worked as intended. So, Berensky, it's time for a yay. We did it. VIP mission finished. And we even have 3 turns left over. So that was good. Friday evening, guys, and all of the missions were successful so far. What could be more beautiful than that? 3 promotions. Good job. So Arnob, I'm looking at you, Revival Protocol, because the Storm Lancers are not to be underestimated. Haywire is a good thing. I am seriously considering Revival Protocol. Because the Storm Lancers are really, really, really annoying. Let's go with Haywire. Maybe I'm regretting it, but yeah. Lightning Hands, Ambassador, Blast Padding is not bad as well. Oh, Shredder is good though. His grenades will take a lot of the shredding work. So let me double check if Blast Padding is any good. For you, for the record, I have modified blast padding, so it's no longer an optional one armor. You could actually build up something quite decent here. So I'm thinking about. We need a lot of shredder because very soon armor is going to be a real issue. This here means a lot more survivability pretty early on. Let's try it because I wanted to give also the other skill options a go. Let's try it. I think with the new modification, because I doubled it, it should actually be pretty good. And I also think that I'm disconnected from the chat because I haven't seen anything after Nitro mentioning. I don't know why I'm even trying to give you an advice. Or the chat is awfully quiet. Yeah, usually I'm taking Shredder, but let's use Ambassador as a test case to try a new setup. Let's use him as a test case. I want to see if it's any good. Alright, here we go. Supply drop from the resistance, a soldier. Soldier is not bad, but grenade is even better. And supply drops is also fine, but let's go for the grenade. Plotting new course. Pyrogen grenade and venom rounds. Okay, so the pyrogen is interesting. Venom rounds are also interesting. The pyrogen is the most damage over time based grenade. I would still consider it the worst of the grenades, but I haven't really found a way how to fix it yet. Because damage over time is just not good, that's Avenger the problem. New course. Let me reload chat, by the way, because I don't see any updates. Can't believe no one is writing something. Yeah, the color coding doesn't work with the new classes. Obviously, that is not implemented correctly. Chat's reloaded now, by the way. Good. We have no more rookies to train. Let's recruit one rookie and train him. Wow, there are a lot of nice rookies here. Even Irish Mike is here. Warnai. Roby. Yeah. If you can find me, pick me up. Nitro, I was looking for you, specifically for you, but you're the only fucking rookie that is not available. Nitro is a rare good nowadays. I don't even have a no-name rookie that I could name after you, because all of these guys are actual viewers. So, sorry, bro. Sorry, bro. Now the game today it doesn't like you. That's I'm not going to lie. So the last rookie. Which class do we need? With the Grenadier being gravely wounded, I think we need another Grenadier, which pretty much seals the deal, because I know the only Grenadier that we definitely need is the one and only, the true Roby. He always has been a Grenadier, so when we talk about a new Grenadier, like, Roby is probably the first choice there. Maybe I'm in the soldier drop. Yeah, that might be the case, man. So, we do have a moderate protect the device. Not really what I would want to do. Or an easy... Neutralize Advent VIP on a PR tour. That's bad. I don't like that. but protect the device isn't much better. And the Avatar project, we want to counter that here. And supplies are good. What's the reward here? Do we get a scientist? Yeah, a scientist reward is better. Hmm. Yeah, we really need to get the scientist because we are super far or super slow when it comes to research. Let's get the supply drop. It's only one more hour. Yeah, please. Okay, ignore. Ignore, and then we're going
setting course for sector one.
For that one here. Scientist, confirm. Protect the device. Always a good option to completely fail, because it's a hard mission type. Moderate means there are going to be four packs, which is not easy. Grenades. Damage, damage, even more damage, and we need healing. Specialist. Okay. Are we fine with no scout? Hmm. Let's get the scout here. Respectively, the ranger. Make utility items available. Yes, please. Make weapons available. Yes, please. And we start from the left to the right. No, we don't need the stock on him. He's going to be fine with his normal weapons. But I think giving him the flashbang grenade isn't too bad, so that's a good idea. Giving our sniper the venom rounds is probably an excellent idea. Venom rounds deal also 2 bonus damage, so that's good. And organic targets will suffer a severe debuff, but the damage over time will be a little bit lower than as compared to what are they called? Dragon rounds. Can we build the Viper rounds now as well? No. Would have been too good to see Viper rounds being available here. That would have been very, very nice. Alright, Strelok. Smoke grenade, big fat HMG. I think we should go for the pyrogen grenade because it still has a little bit larger radius. So it's a bigger radius than the frag grenade. It has 3 additional damage, it shreds even more, and I think it will debuff quite substantially. So let's just take one grenade. I still think it's a good grenade. We just need to double check if it's on par with the other grenades. Alright, let me edit him and give him the weapon upgrade. Yes, please. Weapon upgrade. Stock. Yeah. Good. So we got ourselves healing, defense, defense, damage, more damage. Looks like a solid team to me. Here we go, gentlemen. Oh, did you give your engineer work? No, because I'm a scrub.